this video, we're going to be taking a look at how to play the guitar solo from the Queen song These Are the Days of Our Lives, which we find on the 1991 Queen album Innuendo. In the description of this video, there's a link to a video I've just made of playing it along with the record with the guitar tab on the screen, so that you can learn all the different guitar fills that it takes to be able to play the song in its entirety. But before we do that, we'll take a look at the guitar solo being played close up along with the record. So the song itself is in the key of C, which should help us when it comes to playing this record. And the phrase that we hear just before the guitar solo starts is this. Which on the 8th fret of the high E string, moving to the 5th, to the 8th fret of the B string. And up here. And the guitar solo almost overlaps that as that's being played. So as the guitar solo starts, we hear this phrase. So bending that 8th of the B string up. We bend and release the 8th again. On the G string, 10-9. Still on G, 7-9, 10-9. So we should hear that. We then hear this phrase. Still on G, bending the 10th up, 10-9, 10-7. We then have this phrase, so we're going 9-7 all on the G string, open 7, moving to the 9th, we're going to bend and release, 7-9-7, a kind of hammer on and pull off with that, finishing on the 10th of D, so we have that. We then come to this phrase. All on the G string, we're going to go 14-12. We're going to bend the 14th up. Hit it again. And then we're going to hit the 12th fret. If we listen to the record, that note almost sounds like it's been chopped off. It kind of stops dead. We then have this phrase. Which is probably it's got a lot of delay on it. So we're starting on the 10th fret of the B string, moving to the 12th fret of the high E and bending that up. Like that. We then go on and bend and release the 12th of the high E, moving to the 10th, to the 13th of B. We're then going to go from the 10th of high E, moving through the 13th and 10th of the B, to the 12th of G. Then from the 10th of B, 12, 10, 9 on the G, 10, 9 on G again, 12, 10 on D, from the 12th to the 14th on D. And again, it drags off. So we should have that. Oops. We're then going to play really watch the same phrase again, but this time starting on the 12th fret of B, from, obviously the guitar tab's on the screen to make this a lot clearer. 12th fret of B, moving at the 14th of high E. Going to bend and release the 14th of high E. Moving to the 12th, 15th of B. We're then going to make a run from the high E, 12th fret, moving at B, 15, 12, to the 14th of G. We're then going to make a run from the 12th of B, moving to the G string, 14, 12, 11, then 12, 11 on G, 14, 12 on D, finishing on the 15th of B. Then have this phrase. So on the 15th fret of B, we're going to bend and release, moving to the 13th, to the 12th. Then all on the G string, we're going to go 14, 12, 14, 16. Like that. So we should have that. Sliding into the 16th. We then finish off with this phrase. So on the 12th fret of G, kind of palm muting that, I'm going to go. Then 15th of B, 13, 12, 13. Sorry. And then we'll kind of finish, kind of fades out on the 15th of the high E. So I'll play that through slowly and deliberately before we take another look at it being played along with the record. As always, thank you all for watching. I hope that helps you be able to play the guitar solo from These Are the Days of Our Lives, and we'll now take a look at it being played again with the record.